Harriet Ntabazi, the Minister of State for Trade, has presented a statement on skyrocketing prices of essential commodities and attendant actions undertaken by government to control the situation. The minister told Parliament that there is no cause for alarm. The rise in prices in Uganda is much lower than what is happening in other economies, including Uganda's neighbors.
Also, notwithstanding the 10% import duty, which was levied last year on the crude palm oil, a raw material for cooking oil and soap, which was last financial year, which increased the factory prices by 6% for palm oil and 38% for soap in the country. Madam Speaker, Indonesia has imposed export limit for palm oil product of 20% for domestic markets, leaving 80%, Madam Speaker, only for export markets. And this is where we are getting
In on the issue of fuel prices, she says that Uganda's fuel prices are lower than what is in Kenya and Tanzania.
Madam Speaker, when compared to our neighbors in Kenya, a litre of fuel has gone up to 6,800. And our neighbors in Tanzania, they have gone to 6,000. And we are at 5,800. So there is a struggle.
Honorable Harris, the cost of living in the other country vis-a-vis the cost of living here. Stop comparing.
She, however, faced resistance on the floor when she told the House the government is partnering with other stakeholders such as Bidco to scale up the production of palm oil in the country, which legislators found a long-term strategy that can't provide immediate solutions to the current crisis.
Is putting in a lot of effort to expand the production of palm oil with the support of Bidco and other companies to areas of Vuvuma, expansion of Kalangala, Bundibujo, the Greater Masaka, and other areas where we shall find land.
Talk of Tanzania, most of these countries have reduced on the taxes of fuel so that they could remain, prices remain within. What you want us to tell us, be honest with ourselves. You know, as the speaker put it, we want to know what my old man can get to know.
Came up with proposals that are for a long term. We are not talking about 4 years. We are talking about now and now. What can we do for government to reduce on the prices, on the commodities? So we are like, if the government is levying too much taxes, it is time for government to appreciate and slow down and scale down the prices in terms of taxes, such that the commodities can be cheaper for the people.
The speaker, Anita Among, put the minister to task to tell the House about the short-term interventions that government is putting in place. Among demanded for immediate solutions to the escalating prices of essential commodities across the country and rejected the minister's report.
And me may not appreciate that the prices are high because of what we earn, but a person locked down there in the village in Bukedea, he's feeling it so much. So it is our responsibility for us to know and explain and get a solution to that. And the solution that we should get, since you said the government is not sitting, the solution that we should have should be an immediate solution, middle-term solution, and then the long-term solution.
The Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, has accepted the parliamentary decision and promised to have a joint meeting between responsible ministries to find a clear solution and return back to Parliament with a robust report.
We have a meeting involving the following ministries. Minister of Trade, the one that has presented this. Prime Minister's Office, National Planning Authority, and the Minister of Finance, so that we come up with a conclusive paper that we shall bring back here on the floor of Parliament. But of course, you know that there are those things we have done. That's why the inflation of Uganda has not escalated.
Prices of fuel, soap, cooking oil, yeast, among others, started escalating earlier this year due to factors that have remained not clear to the public. This report was compiled by Fred Kajwi for the news in Parliament.